Hello friends, in the last tutorial, how to insert our beginners inserting into the database. Okay, we talked about insertion of data into the database, isn't it? So please, if not that tutorial, this tutorial will depend on the other one. In this tutorial, I'm not going to discuss how to insert data, okay? But I'm going to probably just give you some brief explanation. I'm not going to start from scratch, okay? So this is what we designed. It was a form. This is a group box. It has two text boxes and a button known as add, okay? So to insert data, we used system.data.sql server say, okay? Then we created a connection, SQL connection con is equal to new SQL connection. We provided a data source, okay, which guides us to where the database is, okay. So my database is known as foreignerdb.sdf. It is in my documents. This is just the path. But before writing the path, you have to specify this data source here, or it won't work. You have to also put this at sign, or else it will give you an error. Then we created an adapter, okay. Then I came to this insert into database. Here I passed the name and the country, okay, the both strings. I opened the connection. I inserted using a SQL command, okay. Then I added the values. Then I verify using int affected rows is equal to cmd.execute now query. If affected rows is greater than 0, meaning that something has been added into the database, okay? Display successfully inserted rows, else failed to insert, okay? So that is how we went. We caught exceptions. I wrote, this was also just a helper method for displaying, okay. So to confirm that data was in the info, let's come here to the server explorer, then the table, then show table data. You can see the data. These are the data that we inserted, okay. So today we're going to discuss how to retrieve that data, okay? Retrieve data, okay? Okay, so actually what's going to happen is that in this form, let me extend this form, sorry, I'm going to extend this form so that I can also add some more components that will display for us the data, okay? The data that is selected. So I'll bring in a group box, put it here. Yeah, new group box, okay? So I'll just give it some text property. I'll say data in database or retrieved data in database, okay. Then I'll bring the list box is where those data will be displayed. So just come, select list box, okay. So bring it here. I won't interfere with the name. I'll just leave it list box one. I think I'll be able to remember that one. Then I'll add a method. Okay. I'll add a method that will be a method that will update the list when called. Okay. So I'll name the method update button. I'll give it the text property update, then name it update button. Okay, now let's go to the code. So the very first thing that we're going to do, we're going to add a list. Okay, we're going to create a list that will be used. Okay, list that will be used to hold data temporarily. Okay, temporarily. So let's give it to be a list of type string. List of type string. I'll call it names. Okay. Names is equal to new. That's our list. Now let's come to the method. Let's write a method for retrieving the data. So this method, it will return a list. Okay, so let's give it private list. It will return a list of type string. Okay, list of type string, and then we'll say retrieve data. This retrieve data method will return a string, or will return a, it will return a list. Okay, so let's come. The first thing that we have to do is to open the connection. Okay, we have to open the connection using con.open. Right, that's the first thing that we're going to do. Okay, the second thing that we're going to do is that we're going to select. In fact, that's the main thing we come here to learn. Okay, select data. So what we're going to do, we're going to use SQL say command. So just say SQL say command cmd is equal to new SQL say command. In this here, what we are going to pass, we are going to pass select and a select statement. We are going to select asterisk from. Okay, what's the database? The database we said is here, foreignerdb.sdf. foreignerdb.sdf. Okay, then we'll need a data reader that will read that data. So let's say SQL data reader, SQL say data reader, let's call it reader is equal to new SQL say data reader. Okay, yeah, no, I'm doing a big mistake, a foolish mistake. Okay, this one, SQL data reader is equal to cmd.execute dot execute reader. Okay, not the way I did it. cmd.execute reader. Okay, so how are we going to read that data? We're going to read it using a while loop. Okay, we're going to use a while loop. Okay, so say while read reader.read. Okay, while reader.read. So this will iterate. Okay, it will loop through the database reading the data, and which data particularly do you want? What? I only want a name. string name is equal to, okay, so it's only the name that we are going to add to the list, okay, only the name. So say reader dot get string okay reader dot get string then let's pass the position of that name. I think the name is the first one in the table. It's the first in the, when you go to the table, it's the first thing, it's in the first frame. Okay? So this string, for each loop, this string called name, it will hold, okay? It will hold the value of the name in the database, okay? So that value is what we are now adding to the database. So to the list, I mean, so say list dot add, and then come, what do we add? We add the name, okay? Yeah, then after that one, we come and close connection. Say con dot close, okay? Yeah, then what are we going to return? We are going to return names, okay? The names which will have been updated. So what we do is simple. Let's come here with the update function. We want to add that list, okay? We want to add that list to the list box. So say list box one dot items dot add range, because we're going to add a whole list, okay? So we are going to call the method retrieve data, which is going to retrieve the data. But remember, this method is a list, so we have to convert it to array. So say to array, okay? Then let's run the program and see. Okay, if we call it, okay, we have an error. So let's come and see. Unhandled exception of type invalid operation occurred. Connection property has not been initialized. Okay. Oh my god. A very silly error. Okay, so the error is that, this is the, where the error is, connection has not been initialized, which is true here. So please just come here and add the con stuff. I mean, even to make it better, I think it would be fine if we add the try catch. It's a good practice to catch those errors, okay? So let's say try catch. Exception exception okay, X. Then let's display the error. Display the error. X dot message. So finally, let's just close the thing, the database, before returning the name. Okay, so we can run the program. Invalid token, the table name is not valid. Token line not known. Silly errors. Let's come again. very silly error. This one is person DB. Okay. I'm making very, very silly error. This is person DB. Let's call person TB. I'm not sure why he was choosing these funny names. Token line, line not known, token line offset. Cable line, that is DF. Please forgive me for making these silly errors. Okay, this one, this .sdf should not be here. Okay, .sdf is a database name, but this is a table. The table just remains here. I think right now it should work. Very, very silly mistakes. Please forgive me for that. Okay, so right now if I update, you can see, okay? You can see that it has selected the values and put them in the row, okay? Now if I come and change this one to 0, let's see. Okay, John, Michael, Amy, okay? So that is how the select statements work. So please, I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please, if you want more of this, please subscribe, comment, and rate this video if you liked it. I want to thank you for being patient, okay? So see you next time.